Am I audible?
Yes.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to the second session for the day on convolutional neural networks. I'm extremely happy to introduce the speaker for the session, Dr. Sriraj M., Assistant Professor, Sri Ayappa College, Cheggannur. Dr. Sriraj started his career as a project assistant in GIS research project under Kerala State Remote Sensing and Environment Center, Trivandrum. After his PhD in 2013, he worked as an assistant professor in FISAT. He is an active researcher in the field of natural language processing, human-computer interaction, image processing, data mining, neural networks, and GIS. He has undertaken two major projects supported by ISRO and KSCST in the field of natural language processing and human-computer interaction. He has about 25 research papers in his credit, and that too in reputed journals like IEEE, Taylor and Francis, Emerald, Springer, etc., and in international conferences as well. He has got an opportunity to visit Russia for presenting an international conference. He has chaired and is a reviewer of various international conferences. On behalf of everyone present out here, I welcome Dr. Sriraj to the session. Over to you, Dr. Sriraj. It's all yours.
Okay. First of all, thank you to the organizers for me to invite this series of FTP conducted by the Department of Computer Applications, CSAT. I think it's audible for you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
You are.
Fine. So I'm going to mention about. Can you see my presentation?
No, sir.
Okay, right. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So, no, it's happened like that. Wait. Open with the Chrome itself. Fine. Okay. So my duty is to introduce CNN, and that's called as convolutional neural network. Okay. So before going to that convolutional neural network, we need to find the term, what is a convolution means. In mathematics, the convolution is a mathematical operation, like what the addition or an multiplication as well as subtraction. And we consider this convolution as a mathematical operation, so on two functions. Definitely the functions may be written as what f and g, and that produces a third function expressing how the shape of one is modified by the other. Okay, so the term convolution refers to the both the result of the functions and the process of computing it. And of course it is widely applicable in the case of what the image processing as well as in the case of the signal processing. Okay, that's not my duty to what introduce the convolution for you. I think all of you may be familiar with this convolutional neural network. Anyway, I will show that what are the intermediate results may happen in the case of an each layer of the convolutional neural network. And what are the parameters to be considered in the case of an application set? What are the limitations mainly focused in the case of a convolutional neural network, and how the research is going to happen in nowadays? Okay, so better before going to start this introduction or the explanation regarding that convolutional neural network, let me see a simple example and observe this video. Okay, this is not with respect to the convolutional neural network. Anyway, so you need to understand. So this is a drawing of an Abdul Kalam. Just listen this. Okay, thank you. So I think you got that video or that how to draw a figure of a particular person. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So what's the peculiarity of that drawing? That's my question. Actually, an artist is trying to draw a figure of an Dr. Abdul Kalam as a cartoon. You have you think that, and only the edges are mainly focused for what drawing that photo. Am I right? Clear?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So the main job of that deep learning is what to obtain that corresponding feature from an input image and to make into a classification purpose. And the one of the limitation of that shallow learning, that's the case of the older days, is that is new obtain that appropriate features, then only we can find a better solution for a particular project. Okay, so avoiding these limitations, and the researchers mainly focus into how can we obtain a feature from an input like that drawing. Okay, so as an artist, he mainly focused on the edges of the particular person. Okay, so already we know that the convolutional operation is mainly used in the case of the spatial domain as a filters. In the case of otherwise, we can say that this is a more or less equivalent to what the multiplication operation in the case of a frequency domain. Okay, and vice versa, you can see that. Okay, so this kind of operation, that means we can obtain the edges from an image using some set of filters mainly used in the case of image processing. And the same thing can be obtained using what a feature corresponding for a particular person. Already we see that, and the drawing of an Abdul Kalam is mainly with respect to what certain edges only. Okay, so this intention is mainly dealt with what the convolutional neural network. Okay, so first of all, we need to find that edge detections, and it must be passed with respect to what the densely connected neural networks. Of course, this is an example for a densely neural network, and where the inputs are passing like this. Okay, and it is connected to what there's several number of hidden layers, and of course, you know about that. What after that particular steps of what hidden layers, we will get an output layer corresponding with respect to what the certain activation functions. Definitely, we will get a classification result. Yeah. So, and how can we find and obtain a feature with respect to this kernel? And then that's the leading point in the case of the convolutional neural network. Okay. So mainly we are using the convolution as an operation to obtain the feature with respect to an input, and from that feature can be converged to a classification task. Classification in the sense that can we obtain an output result in a good manner. Okay. So this is an example for an data called 9, and you can see that this 9 is written as with respect to what the white, and the background is already, you can know that it's a black. So this is in a case of what expressing with the zeros as well as 255 with respect to what the RGB manner. Okay, so and this is a pretty example of what the convolution operations, and already you know about the case of the image processing techniques. You are, once we are familiar with that image convolution, you know about this. I'm not going to that details. Okay, instead, my job is what to introduce this convolution and can we obtain an edge and which may be lead to a feature part in the case for the classification purpose. Through that way, we can understand the convolution neural network as well as how to build the convolution neural network and what are the intermediate results come after each layer in between the case of the several layers which we have mentioned in the case of this neural network. Okay, clear? So in case of an input image, and we are convoluting that input image with a particular type of kernel like this, definitely we will get a feature map like this. That means we need to, I made that result according to that the previous equations, using the previous equations. You can see that it is an one by one element into multiplications, and as well as we are taking the summation of that entire values. Okay, so this is a particular window which is corresponding with respect to what the kernel size. So the kernel size is an important parameter. Okay, clear? So it may be lead to, it may be changed from what 3, 5, 7, something else. Okay, and in this example, you can see that what I am using a 3x3 kernel, and of course the image must be at a square type, and that's another important things which we are considering in the case of a convolution neural network. And our input image must be what, in a square type. Okay, clear? So I'm going to consider that's a 3x3 kernel, and it is convoluted with respect to an input image, so-called this image. And you can see that I'm going to multiply with the 10 into 1 plus 10 into 2 plus 10 into 1. Again, I am going to add with respect to what, the 10 into 0, because the second row corresponding for this input image of a particular window size of a kernel. Okay. And thus we will get a result like this, still 0. Okay. So when we move to that next stride, we call this as a stride. That means what? We need to consider that next window positions. So this is also another important parameter. So already we have seen three parameters. One is the size of that input image as well as the size of that kernel. Okay. And the next one is what? The stride parameter. Stride parameter means what? The traversal of a particular window from an order of what, from the left to right or something else, and how to move that. It's maybe a single column or a double column. We can switch that case. I'm here considering it's a single stride. Okay, instead of the single stride, if you're going to consider this as a two stride, then definitely the window will be start over here. Okay, clear. So that's in the case of the input image. Again, I am going to calculate the value as a zero. Of course, this is corresponding for a vertical edge filter. Sorry, not the vertical edge, it's the horizontal edge. Horizontal edge, obtain the horizontal edge using this particular filter. Okay. And then again, I move to that next stride and got that result as a zero again. Okay, and move. And after that, reaching that endpoint of the right portion of that input image, I need to switch the second row. Okay, so the second row, the calculation is like this. I got a result like this. It's a 40 instead of the zero, as we have previously seen in the case of the previous slide. Okay, so we got, that means what, we are obtaining a horizontal edge corresponding for this purpose, this input image. Of course, this can be seen as that what, this is a black area. And this is somewhat light when we compare with this area, because it has a value called 10, and this is purely black. That means what? It says this image has the value called 0. Already we know that the image has the value ranges from 0 to 255, where 0 is considered as the black and 255 is considered as the white. Okay. So, and when we apply these kernel functions, our convolution with this particular kernel, definitely we will get what, the result is 40. Okay. And again, we are repeating the same process, and definitely we will get the next result. Okay, through that way, we can say that what, the first row will consist of the values of 40. And again, we move to the next row. And again, we will get what, that next result. Okay, and the same manner, and we are repeating this process, and unless we are reaching that the end of that image. So after that, moving to that end of the day, or in the case of that entire process, you will get a result like this. The first row consists of the 0, and the second row consists of what, 40, and next row consists of 40, again there's 40, and next row is consists of about what, 0. That means what, there is a horizontal edge corresponding with respect to what, this portion. This is a input portion. Okay, like that, and we can obtain a feature like this and come to the point of an illustration like this. And this is a good image. Instead of this is in the case of a convolution operation, in the case of the single filter operation. Okay, when we apply the horizontal filter, definitely we will get an horizontal edges corresponding for a particular input. Okay, fine. I think you are understand that the convolution operation. Okay, so my first job is over. I give the clear cut definition for the clear cut illustration for the case of what, the convolution with respect to any 2D image. Okay. So how can we use this scenario with respect to convolution operation? That's the next job. Okay. Before going to that, instead of this single filter, if I'm going to consider the multiple filters with the different scenarios, different in the sense that maybe a vertical, maybe a another shape of that edges, definitely we will get what the corresponding edges with respect to an input image. So let me see that. And this is the input image. I'm going to consider what, first of all, I'm going to consider this, the previous filter. Definitely we will get that horizontal wedges corresponding for that each with respect to that input image. Clear? Okay. So, and if I'm going to change that horizontal filter with respect to a vertical filter like this, what will happen? Definitely it will be recognized that corresponding vertical filters of a particular input image. Okay. Yes. And again, I'm going to change that the filter with respect to that, this is the another filter. Definitely the corresponding output will be shown over here. Okay, I think it's clear. Okay, so and again I'm going to this scenario, definitely I will get a parameter like this. Okay, so so actually these, and this is quite resemblance with the analogy which we are followed in the case of the first introduction of that drawing of that Abdul Kalam. Okay, in that scenario, the artist is only focused in the case of the maximum edges, which can be used as the characteristics of a particular person called Abdul Kalam, Dr. Abdul Kalam. Okay, like that, we can obtain these edges with respect to what the, these different filters. Definitely, we can what find the appropriate features. Maybe it looked like that corresponding image. Okay, fine. So we got a stuff, that means what, we got a point like this, and can we use this important factor or important characteristics for to recognize or maybe lead to a decision making purpose using a neural network for a classification purpose? Definitely, that's the main job in the case of what, convolution neural network. So one thing to be important in the case or this case, if you are going to use this kind of multiple filters, and what should be the size of that each output of that each layer output, if I'm going to use these multiple filters in a first layer in the sense that I'm giving that input image as an input layer of a neural network. Okay, so I'm not, we in case of the neural network, we are not considering that input as an input layer. So if you are going to calculate the total number of layers, it will start from starting from what, the first hidden layer to that output layer. We are considering the first hidden layer and second hidden layer and up to what n number of hidden layers, and then we count that total number of hidden layers, and then we calculate adding with respect to what the output layer. Okay, so that's the total number of layers in the case of what, neural network. Okay, so in that perspective, if you are going to supply this input image as the input layer, okay, and according to that first hidden layer, I'm going to convolute with a set of, in the case of the previous layer, we have previous explanations, we have seen that one, in the case of dense layer, we have seen that the several neurons and the corresponding neurons, we are making that in case of that consider this each neuron as a convolution operation corresponding for a particular kernel. Okay, so this is corresponding for a horizontal one, and this is corresponding for a vertical one. This is maybe with respect to a diagonal one, and this is maybe with respect to what, at other filters. Okay, like that we can define what the multiple number of filters in the first layer. Okay, clear. And definitely we will get what the results corresponding for the, or definitely we will get an edges corresponding for a particular input. Okay, from that input we need to obtain that maximum value or some characteristics things, and that may lead to what the classification purpose. And we need to consider that some of the parameters, and already we mentioned that the size of that input image must be square, and also the size of the filter is also is the same size. That means 7 by 7. According to our needs, we need to change that kernel size. Okay, so the bother about the case of the parameter for to calculate that next number of neurons in the next layer, we need to bother about the case of the what should be the output shape of this first hidden layer. Okay, that means first convolution operation. For that purpose, we need to some equations to be needed to understand what should be the output size. And here we are going to consider the parameter called the padding. And in the previous example, we did not use any padding styles. So the padding is with respect to what the filter dimensions. And so usually it's an odd one, and f minus 1 divided by 2. In here we are using what 3 by 3 is the size. So 3 minus 2 divided by 2, it's a padding is 1. Okay. So P is has a value called 1, and where P is the padding and F is the filter dimension. And now come to the point of the calculations. Number of output can be calculated, and this is a floric function, and this is with respect to the number of input plus 2P minus F, where P is already calculated with respect to that F minus 1. It's the number of the size of that filter, F minus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so we need to find the dimensionality of that output layer, output shape. So now, already we know that the input image has a size of a square by square, a square size. So in case of that previous example, with respect to this example, you can calculate that we are going to calculate this our feature map size. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a 6 by 6 size of an input image, and has a kernel size of 3 by 3. Okay, so we need to substitute that value. Definitely, it's a 6 plus 2p. P is what? Already we calculated this as 1. So 6 plus 2, it's 8. 8 minus f. F is the size of that filter. That's called as 3 by 3. Again, it's a 3. So 8 minus 3 is what? 5. Okay. I'm right. And the case of the stride window, we are using only what? It's only what single. And so there is no change. And plus 1. And so it has a size called 3 plus 1 is 4. Yes, the shape of that output must be what? It's a 4 by 4. Let's check that. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So we got that feature map of size 4 by 4. Clear? Yes. So again, we can calculate this kind of output calculation from that input image. And already we know that what should be the output of that particular layer. Okay. And then we need to move to that next layer, and how many filters to be chosen for that next layer. And again, we are obtaining what same kind of edges among that edges. And like that, we can.
Sir, yes. Sir, may I interrupt? Ms. Vinita has sent you a message. Sir, could you please repeat what is S?
Okay, S is a stride. Stride means what? We are moving that. I'm not seeing that. That's why I'm not focusing the case of that chat. Okay.
No worries, sir. I'm checking it.
Okay. Okay. So in case of that moving the window, we are already fixed the size of that kernel. It's a 3 by 3. We need to convolute the 3 by 3 with respect to that input image. Okay. And we need to traverse through the entire image. Then only we will get what the corresponding edges corresponding for an input image. Okay, so we need to move from what a one portion to that entire portions. So let me check that case. In the case of that first purpose, and we choose this as the first starting point. Okay, so and after this 3 by 3, I am going to move this to that next column. Okay, and next column in the sense that I'm going to consider that the 3 by 3 of window as mentioned in the case of this example. Okay, so I just move only the one column to the right from the previous column. Okay, so that's why this is a stride, which called as S. I think I'm clear. I make the answering for that question. Yeah. So here we are considering that stride is equal to 1. That means we are moving from only the one position from the previous column. Okay, instead of that, we can move from what, either we can choose what, instead of one, we can choose two or three according to our needs. But mainly we are using this one as the default one, because we need to obtain that each and every features corresponding for that input image. Okay, and but in the case of that other certain scenario of that process, we need to change that scenario, means that's stride operations may be changed with respect to two, three or something else. And we need to check that whether it is applicable for our project, and whether it shows a decrease or increase in the case of our results. Okay, clear? Yes. Okay. So like that, we can calculate what already we mentioned, that the size of that size of the newly output image is like this, n into n in C, where the number of counts of the kernels is usually like this, and normally. And already we mentioned that the dimension of the received tensor. Okay, then one more factor is to be considered here. We are not considering in the case of what as a single vector or single two-dimensional vector for this purpose. And instead, we need to calculate, we need to use what a tensor operation. And a tensor, I think you are familiar with the tensors. And otherwise, I'll just give an, a simple example. Simple example in the case of the tensor to be look like this. I think you are familiar with the cubics, Rubik's cube. Okay. And actually the Rubik's cube size is what, 3 by 3. Okay. Yes. Actually the size of the Rubik's cube is 3 by 3, and within the 3 by 3 itself, the only the front portion itself, you can see that there is a 9 cubes are there. Am I right? And also there's other 9 cubes are in the case of the top as well as left and bottom as well as the rear part of the front part of that. Anyway, this is, can we see that? Okay. And each of that particular cell or each of the particular cubes again is a 3 dimensional. Okay, and this is a quite example. That means what, within the 3 by 3 size, we can what, incorporate another 3 by 3. 3 by 3 means what, it's a 3 dimensional. Three size of that, maybe in the case of your thing with the unit expression, it's 1 by 1 into 1, as 3 dimensional. I'm mentioning about the 3 dimensional. So again, that inner part, we can use that what dimensionality, or that that's called as a so-called tensor for that kind of case of what obtaining that feature. Okay, fine. So and we need to consider this as a tensor. So that's the 3D max or 3D matrix, and can be called as a tensor, maybe mainly used for this purpose. Okay, so these are the calculations. So you can see that what I'm going to consider in the case of an RGB image, and that entire scenario is changing like this. It's a 6 by 6, with the previous example, it's a 6 by 6 of 3, because there are 3 layers corresponding for RGB, where R is corresponding, this R is the first layer, and G is the second layer, and C is, B is the third layer. And if you are convoluting with the, in this example, as illustrated in the figure, you can see that there are 3 kernels are of the same size in the sense that it's a 3 by 3 of 3. Okay, definitely we will get an output of what, 4 by 4 into 1. And definitely it will be merged like this, 4 by 4 of 1. Okay, and already we are applying what, the 3 kernels. Definitely, again, the output is what? It's a size of 3 by, means RGB format with the size of what? 4 by 4 by 3. That means we are reducing from that input image, so-called 6 by 6 3, into what, 4 by 4 of 3. Clear? And it considers only the feature in the sense that the edges corresponding with respect to what? That input image. Okay. So the next question is erasing. Does we need all these edges? Okay, so that may be the next question for the purpose of the classification. So we don't need that entire edges for this purpose. That's why we need to and focus and remember that in the case of the starting of this session with respect to a cartoonist, and he draws only the maximum strength or the maximum characteristics which we are given for a particular patient. That's called as so-called Dr. Abdul Kalam, and he is selecting for that edges and make that draw corresponding for that. Okay, so that's why, and similar way, we can, if you're observing like that, among these edges, we need to choose only the set of or the set of edges which have the maximum value. So that should be the next operations to be incorporated along with this convolution. Then only we can say that our first layer is over with respect to that deep neural network or the convolutional neural network. That's called as max pooling. We need to select that, or we are selecting a pooling from that edges. So, okay. So that's why, and in the case of the feature map, you can see that what if you are going to illustrate with the neurons or the figure like this, I can already, we have said, in this figure, you can see that it's a 3x3. So that 9 is the input image, input neurons, and with respect to a kernel of size 2x2, instead of the previous one, it's a 3x3. Okay, definitely we will get a feature map like this. It's a 2x2 with the calculations. And definitely we can say that what, if you are going to choose this, this is the first input image and corresponding kernel is operating. You can see that a certain other neurons is not being participated to obtain that A. Only 1, 2, 4, 5 is going to participate in the case of to obtain the feature A. Okay. And in the case of what, 2, 3, 5, 6 in the case of what, B. Okay. And next one is what, with respect to C. So that means certain neurons are winning for what, obtaining the feature for obtaining the edges corresponding for particular input. That means we need to that's why we are saying that we need to what, the pool of the certain features among out from that output of the first convolution operation. Okay, so I'm not going to that forward pass and backward pass. Already we know that you know about because it's time is very less to illustrate that implementation regarding that convolution operation. Okay, anyway, I just mentioned that there is a forward pass as well as backward pass. I will mention that I'm not dealing with that equations. Okay. In case of the backpropagation, mainly we are using that backpropagation scenario with respect to this convolution neural network. That means we are passing this case of that input image and it's in the forward pass, and definitely we will get what some so-called error. And if you are going to increase, and that's another important part in the case of the deep neural network, we have to focus on that case. If you are going to increase the more number of layers in the case of a deep neural network, which maybe reached to a good accuracy point, okay, but it creates a problem also. That means it's called as a vanishing gradient point, okay, and also vanishing gradient descent as well as vanishing gradient descent means what? If you are going to increase the more number of layers, that means throughout this process, if you are going to obtain the fine-tuned edges or any feature from that the previous edges, if you are going to add 1, 2, 3 and so many layers, what will happen in the case of after we are obtaining an error? Definitely, we need to give the partial order function for to find that error and adjust the weights value with respect to that previous layers. Okay. And already we know that the partial order derivative, it's only what, a less number of very small values. And if you are going to choose a more number of layers, the weight will not be adjusted. Okay, that means the previous weight will not be, that's lead to a vanishing gradient points. Okay, so that's kind of an illustration is there. That's why we are not using what sigmoid as, we would not deal with the sigmoid as an activation function in these operations. Okay, so our first job is over. We get that input layer and we made a convolution operation with respect to what, a certain number of kernels. Definitely we will get what different edges corresponding for that, and we need to, next job is what, we need to obtain only the maximum edges with the corresponding for that edges which is obtained through that convolution operation. That's why we are using the max pooling. Okay, and after the max pooling, and we need to pass through that and activation functions, whether it is useful or something else. So in case of that activation functions, already we mentioned that this this problem, this vanishing gradient form, is maybe is using because we are using when more number of layers in between input as well as output layers. So we need to change that scenario. That means what, sigmoid layer, and instead we are using definitely we need to what, use the ReLU operation instead of that sigmoid. Okay. So, and because why it happened like this, in the case of a sigmoid, definitely it look like this. And if you are going to take the derivative and it has it is varying only from 0 to maybe 0.3 or 0.2 something else. So, and while in the case of the sigmoid, of in the case of the ReLU operations, and if you're going to change that, if you're going to take the derivative, it will not happen like that. Okay. So, I'm not dealing with that case. So, So that's the scenario. That means what we are obtaining the convolution layer, and in case of that forward pass, we will get an, a result, and comparing with that classification result, and if you are going to get an error, definitely we need to adjust with the previous layer. And the previous layer is with respect to what this kind of activation means, this derivative, and the previous layer is derivative with respect means we need to multiply it. Again, it's convoluted with the previous layer. Okay, so let me move to the illustration of what will happen in the case of an input given for a particular model. Okay, and for that purpose, okay, so I'm going to present okay. So this is a collab, and I can see that what from collab I am going to first of all I need to connect with my drive. So my drive is already mounted, and I'm going to illustrate this figure, this code as a single code, and later we can show that result. Okay, so I'm using here it's a Keras applications, and for to illustrate what is happening in the case of an first layer as well as or what should be the result in between the first layer as well as second layer, or with respect to what the second layer as well as third layer, and like that I need to illustrate like that. And for we need a model means what already predefined convolutional operation, then we can later we can add a write a program corresponding for what this convolutional neural network. Okay, so I'm going to for the purpose I'm going to use the VG network, and this is the first maybe the one of the basic model corresponding for the convolutional neural network, and it consists only the 16 layers. That's why it's mentioned as VGD16. Okay, and it's available in the case of Keras and under the package called the applications. Okay, and you know about what is Keras as well as TensorFlow, and what is the difference between the Keras as well as TensorFlow. Okay. Anyway, if you note that, like, not understand that, and the Keras, think that the Keras is a framework and the high level framework or the top level framework mainly used for what this kind of an applications, and the programmer or the user does not know about what the real implementation regarding that so many algorithms. You can just use that this object oriented concept or call that different functions. Okay, so. And within that, and I need to import that preprocessor input, and next one is when I'm going to load that image, and definitely we need to load that image, and you can see that the import in the model, and plotting that scenario, I'm going to use the matplotlib over here. Okay, and here I'm using what already we mentioned about the TensorFlow applications, and so I'm using a NumPy, mainly it's a numerical Python for that case of that expand dimensional things. Okay, first of all, I'm loading that model into a function into a variable called the model. Okay, I'm redefining the model to that output right after the first hidden layer. I need to get that value. So in here, and let me change that into 8 into 1. Let's check that. So this is the case. And the model, I'm going to use the model. Input model dot inputs that you can see that I'm importing that model over here, and you can see that this is the input model inputs. That means VGG input model is taken, and the output is taken after the first layer, first hidden layer. Okay, so what will happen after the first hidden layer if I am giving that input into that VGG network? That's my job, or that's my intention. Okay. And for that purpose, we need to find, first of all, we need to find that summary of that model. Model in the summary means how many layers are there and what are the parameters and parameter calculations. Anyway, we will discuss in later with the more details. Okay. Definitely, we need to give that input. And for that purpose, I am using that load image function. And corresponding, there is an bad image over here. I think I'll show that. Can you see this image? Yes. Okay. So this is the image, or this is the bed. I'm giving as the input for this entire purpose. Okay. So I'm going to stop this presentation and come to the point of our call. Okay. So back to that call over here. So I'm taking that input image as the bed. I'm giving that input as the bed image, and it has a target size. I need to fix the target size at the 224 into 224. See that that input image with the target size is it's a squared image, because in case of the input image, you have noticed that this is that was not a squared image. So I need to change that entire image into what the squared image. That's why I'm saying I'm considering that 224 into 224. Okay, and convert into an array for that purpose. Convert into array means for the processing of that input image. Already we mentioned it with respect to that previous slide with the circle nature, and we didn't to obtain the feature map corresponding for ABCD something else. Okay, so that array is over here, and expand the dimensionality with respect to the sample. And for that example, means with respect to that image, entire image to be considered over here, and prepare the image with the scale the pixel with the size of the size is there. You can see that it's 1 into 224 into 224, and again we need to preprocess that input image. In preprocess the input image means what? Already we are using that Keras functions for what, preprocessing something. If there is some noise is there, and to reduce that preprocessing stage. Okay, and definitely we need to obtain that feature map corresponding to the first hidden layer. First hidden layer in the case what the feature map is the model dot predict the image, or we are giving it input image, and we are going to find that 64 maps. 64 maps in the sense that in the case of the VGD network, there are 64 channels may be used for that purpose of that case. I mean, definitely we can understand that. Okay, I will mention that case, and it will be plotted with a 8x8 squared. That's why we are mentioning the square over here, and I'm going to mention that the index is at 1, and I need to traverse that. I want to make that the subplot of a size of 8x8. That means the total 64 to be there. So I am using that two for loop for that purpose. And definitely it will be plot the support as the size of what normally first row consists of 8-1, and like that total 8 into 8, total 64 plots to be shown with respect to that feature maps. Okay, and that C map with respect to what the gray level. Okay, clear. And last one is the pie plot with the dot show. That means why we are showing that feature map. Only this much is the program. Okay, I'm going to I think I covered that entire code with respect to that. While I'm going to run this program, you can see that I'm going to run this program. Oh, before that, I need to. Oh, sometimes it will show us. No problem. So you can see that first of all, I given that what the model is loaded into a variable called a model, and after that, you can see that my model.summary is calling. Okay, and for that purpose, according to that model.summary, you can see that the model is like this. And input 9 is input, not bother about the input underscore 9, because I'm running 9 times. That's why I'm changing. If I'm going to run again, it will maybe change. So it's input underscore 10. So you don't bother about the case of the number over here. You have to bother about the case of that layer, input layer, as well as the output shape. Okay. So the first output shape is what 224 224 23, because we are giving that what input image, and with the zero parameter, this is the input image, input layer. Okay, and we are not being concerned as input layer. And what will happen in the case of the block one in the case of the convolution layer, and we are selecting that only the first layer after the first layer. Okay, so it has a size of what 224 into 224 64, where 64 is considered the 64 channels has been used for this purpose, for to obtain that output of that first hidden layer. And this is a parameter. We will discuss about that. How can we calculate the parameter, hyperparameter calculations? Okay. The total parameter is 1792, and the trainable parameters is like this. And the way, and you can see that this is the output corresponding for that purpose. Okay. I think then just zoom out this. Sorry, zoom in the case. Wait. Okay. I think this is, of course, most some of that images is again the same shape as the input image. Okay, but it's the case of the grayscale image, and some of the other images may be illustrated with respect to the some color tone. Okay, of course, that edges is there, and I'm taking this same code, and again, what will happen in the case of what instead of a let me check this case, same case, and need to change this code. Instead of that first layer, I'm going to choose this as a second layer. What should be the output of the after that first, second hidden layer? And see that. Okay, more or less same manner. Somewhat some changes is occur. And what will happen if I'm going to change after that eighth hidden layer? Okay. So many layers are to be illustrated. So the shape is changing. Okay, that means we are going to focus on that that illustration. So that means we are mainly focused on that feature part. Okay, so what will happen if I'm going to, so 16 layer is there. So what will happen in the case of the 14 layer? Okay, you will get what certain prominent features only what it may be used for what the classification purpose. Okay, so the same code is over here, and you can see that the illustration is like this. I'm going to minus this one. Okay, and in case of the VGG network, we are focusing only in the case of what the two. You can see that the model summary is like this. There's an input layer, and then you can see the convolution layer, and again the convolution layer. And here we are seeing that what already we mentioned about the max pooling. Okay, but in the case of this layer, in the case of the VGG network, you can see that the first convolution is going to happen in the case of the first hidden layer, and again another convolution is happening in the next layer. Then only we are operating what the max pooling. Okay, so that kind of changes and that kind of combinations can be done according to your needs. Okay, and then again you can see that this is a single block. Okay, that means the two convolution operations and then a max pooling layer. Okay, and it's repeating after what it's repeating after. That means what the case of the second layer only what we are doing that max pooling. That we are considering that up to second block it's a single block. Okay, then what three and four is together is considering. That means what then only the max pooling is occurring. And there's two is there, then four is there. And what about the next layer? And there's a convolution layer, and again there's a convolution layer, and again there is a convolution layer with the same size of that filter, 256. And then it's taking that max pooling. Okay, so that's a that means what 2, 4 and then what 5, 6, 7 and 8 is there. Okay, so we are going to change, and 9 is there. So we need to taking that as an index, redefine the model output after that different layers. That means what different blocks. Okay, first block is 2 and next one is what there are two convolution layer and max pooling layer is there. So 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to that 5 is there. Up to 5 is the one block is again overing. And next one is what you can see that already we have seen that what after the 9. And like that, we can see that this is the case. And what should be the result after these entire blocks? And the rest of the things are same as in the case of the previous one. And I'm not changing anyone. Only this much is changing. Okay, just run this program. You can see that what this is the first block output layer, first block result, and after that next block you can see that edges is changing. Okay, I think this is very hectic to see the process. Okay, now it's, I think this is, now it's clear, but we cannot see that entire 8x8 in the single window. Okay. Okay, so that's case, and this is a first block, and this is a second block. You can see that what some of the edges may be again showing with respect to that bed itself, and again it's reducing. That means maximum probably important parameters to be considered for the case of the classification. And after that last layer, you can see that what most white parts, or the case of what the most prominent parts may be listed for that case of that for the classification of the bed. Okay, I think you have got an idea regarding that what and what should be the output between each layer. Okay, clear. Yes. So
Yes.
then now we are going to move to that. Sorry. Let's move to the real implementation part. Real implementation in the sense that. Okay. Real implementation in the sense. I just did the short period of time. I need to cancel the call in the program. Wait. So I'm going to cancel the. Okay, so I'm moving to that. I don't know whether it is it's the right time or not. Anyway, I'm going to show that CNN in a color image. That means in the previous example, we have seen that it's a, we are applied in the case of the grayscale value. Instead of a grayscale value, now we are going to consider with respect to the color image as such. Okay, okay, in between that. There are if you have a more time, definitely we can try with certain other algorithm, means certain other programs, then we will reach only the color image. Okay, definitely not have much time. I'm using the TensorFlow tool over here. You can see that I'm for that purpose we am I am importing that statement. Okay, wait for that initialization. Okay, connected. Okay, so and from TensorFlow, I am using an image data generator for the purpose of what documentation as well as image documentations. And here, again, that matplotlib is used for the plotting that scenario. And also, there is a logger is there and for to find that. And here, my job is to find the classified dogs as well as cats. Okay, so I am using the standard data set and. And it is available under the storage.googleaps.com. And I'm using this cats and dogs filtered. Already this is a filtered data set, and I'm downloading the filter set. Wait. Okay, I think so. So that's. Okay. And this consists of a cats and dogs filter, and it consists of a data set. Maybe the. If you are going to use CNN as a algorithm for your research purpose, then we can see that what the, we are mainly using the standard data set for our research purpose. Okay, the standard data set consists of the mainly two parts. One is a training part, and next one is a validation part. Okay, of course that is like that, and you can see that cats is mentioned like this cat0.jpg, and like that n number of cats may be there, and so many number of cat is there, and also dog is there, and the same number another number of cats as well as dogs may be illustrated in the case of the for the validation purpose also. Okay, so I'm going to take that case of the directory path name for the my purpose. You can see that I'm training algorithm training path of corresponding for the cats as well as dogs and also for the case of the validation purpose. Okay, so don't bother with the case of this case of the validation directory as well as training directory. Of course, we will get that directory in the case of our path. And here I'm going to take the path corresponding for the training as well as validation. Then we can see we need to find that number of cats as well as number of dogs in for the training purpose as well as validation purpose. So we need to print the total number of cats as well as dogs. You can see that the total number of cat for the training is 1,000 and dog is 1,000, and again the validation of the total number of the cat is 500 and for the validation of the dog is again 500. So it's an equally more or less equal manner we are taking that case. And of course we can say that this is a, if you are going to consider this and as a entire entity or entire data set, we can say that what the 50% of the data set is considered as the for the validation set. More or less it's not the same as the case of the training purpose. Okay, anyway, the total number of the training sample is 2000 and total number of the validation is 1000. Okay, and this is another thing, and we need to mention about the batch size and evaluation. And batch normalization is an important parameter in the case of what this guy is avoiding that case of the overfitting purpose. You know about what is an overfitting and underfitting conditions, and avoid that underfitting and overfitting conditions. One scenario is mainly we are using in the case of an image augmentation. So we need to focus on what different means different orientations, mainly especially with respect to what the rotation and scaling as well as something else. Okay, I'm not going to that case, and here I'm going to consider that batch size. The number of the training samples to be processed before validating that model's variables. Okay, and the shape of that image is 150. That means already we know that it's a squared image. That's why we are saying that it's a 150 into 150. Okay, disk and decode the contents of the image and convert into a proper format. But here we are not going to convert this into a grayscale. That's the beauty of this algorithm. Okay, so we are dealing with the 3x3 means RGB format itself. Okay, the rescale the entire tensor with the values of the what 0 to 255 values to be converted into a normalization parameter called 0 to 1. Definitely, we need to do that conversion or the normalization. Of course, I believe that you are a clear cut idea regarding that the normalization and so what's the need of that normalization in the case of a deep neural network. Okay. And I'm using that image generator for this purpose. And for the case of the rescale, definitely we know that the how can we rescale an entire data into a scale of 0 to 1? It's simple, very simple, and divide with respect to that maximum value. Okay, so the same process is going to happen over here. You can see that the image using that image data generator and rescaling that entire data with respect to the training data set as well as validation data set. Okay, so I'm going to generate that newly data in the scaled value with respect to the batch size as well as the training directory. And of course, I need to shuffle the data, not been asked in the case which you mentioned in the case of the training directory. Okay. And we need to mention the target size. Already we have seen the target size is mentioned in the case of the previous example. Like that, we need to mention 150 to 150 size. So that's already we have the image shape has consists of a value called 150. Okay. And in this example, we need to what the classify into two. Either it's a cat or a dog. So that's the class mode is only the binary. Okay, and the 2000 images are belongs to one of the two classes. Okay, so in case of the validation data set, I think, and also that validation, you can see that what same process is being over here. And here, we don't shuffle the data set. Why? Because in case of the, if you're going to shuffle the data set in the validation purpose, the our evaluation may be changing. That's maybe happen. It may not be happen like that. Okay, that's why we have shuffle is equal to false is to be mentioned over here. Okay, and come to the point. Next one is what the sample training, and already we select the sample training, and you can see that images corresponding for I am just selecting only the random samples corresponding for the subplots with respect to the figure size of 20 by 20. So you can see that images is like this. You can see that what images of the sample training data set up to what 5. You can see that this is an image corresponding for plotting that images from 0 to 4. That means a total 5 images can be over here. Okay, good. Fine. So our job is over. We are selecting that standard data set is selected, and we convert into the normalization manner, and we divide that entire image into the entire data set into two parts. So one is training part as well as second one is with respect to that training one for the training part and next one is for the validation purpose. Okay, and also we have mentioned about the batch size. Okay. So the first job is over. What should be the next one? We need to mention about that model. Already in the previous example, we are selecting the predefined model for our purpose. Here, we are going to create our own model for the purpose. Okay, so that's why the difference between the previous example as well as this example. Okay, for that purpose, we need to use what the Keras models, and we can consider the sequential model, because all these dense layers are at the case of the previous example which was shown in the case of that slide. You can see that one by one hidden layers may be incorporated, so that this is in a sequential manner. You do not think that CNN is a sequential algorithm. It don't mean like that. Okay, instead LSTM as well as RNN is considered as a sequential algorithm, and CNN is not a sequential algorithm, but it is considered as a sequential part. That's it is mentioned under the Keras. That's why we are using what Keras dot models dot sequential. Okay, sequential in the sense that sequential algorithm has some other relevance. Okay, anyway, we are selecting the sequential, and we are using what convolution operation. And already we need that convolution 2D, and you can see that what the convolution 2D with respect to what We are using a 32 filters over here, having the size 3 by 3. Now you have got an idea what is the 3 by 3. The kernel size is a 3 by 3. And how many kernels are we are using? 32. Okay. And already we mentioned about the activation is a relu. Why? Because it to avoid that what the vanishing gradient design problem. And we are using the relu in between that hidden layers. And only in the case of what output layer, we are using that sigmoid as well as softmax. Okay, then only we will get what the corresponding result. Okay, fine. So that's why we are using activation as a relu over here. And definitely we need to give the inputs shape. And already we know that it's a 150 into 150. And it is, we are going to consider that the 3 RGB. That's why we are saying that it's a 3 over here. Okay, and this is our model consists of what one convolution layer, and after that we are using a max plane, and then again what a convolution. So our block of that convolution layer is consisting like this: one convolution, then followed with respect to what a max plane, then a convolution, then a max plane, like that. We are repeating that process. Okay, and like that we are considering 1, 2, 3, 4 over here. Four blocks are considered the same size, and you can see that the important parameter over here, which is here, can see here it's 32, and next one is 64, and 128, and 128 over here. And you can check with corresponding, and we cannot go in a gradual manner, I mean, not in a rough and other like manner. Anyway, I'm using it like this, and you can see that what after that 120 layer, means after this block of data, I can calculate that output shape using that previous equations, which you have already mentioned in the case of light. Okay. And that should be flattened. That should be flattened in the sense that we consider as a single vector single vector representation. So we are using what the flattened operation, which is present under the layers of the keras. Okay. So then, I am using what after the flattened, I understand that this is a 512, and I need to convert into 512 with connected with a another dense layer called the 512 neurons, and with respect to that activation function value. And last output layer, that this is the output layer, and the output layer means what only, and this is a binary classification, so we need only what the two output. So that's why we are saying that this is a 2 over here, and the activation function is changing from relu to softmax. Okay, so this part is over. Okay, so we are creating the model, and we define the model, and appropriate layers are being mentioned over here. So these are the next step. So second job is over. Okay, and I need to mention about the lot of things with respect to this deep neural network. One parameter is then optimizer. And why? Because already we mentioned about the case of the problems of the vanishing gradient points. And also one more problem is maybe erased. It's a with respect to that, again, the derivatives. And that problem can be solved with respect to the midi batch as well as the several finding out the local minima as well as global minima with respect to what some other parameters. That's an optimization equation. So I'm not going to deal with that case. Anyway, we need an optimizer, and it must be an adaptable optimizer. So it's an error. What should be the error? So cross entropy, after that optimization called cross entropy. Okay. So I'm using that adaptive optimizer. I'm going to consider this as an Adam, and with respect to that sparse categorical cross entropy, sparse categorical cross entropy in the sense that, okay, fine. No problem. So code is changing. Syntax matrix. Okay. We mentioned about the cross entropy. So the several loss functions already we know. Syntax. I need to change check with space. Unexpected intent. There is an unexpected intent. Oof, again it's an error. Okay. Fine. That's I'm using what adaptive optimizer. It's an adaptive optimizer is there. And why I'm using the sparse categorical cross entropy? Because I have to consider only the binary classifications. Binary classification in the sense that we need to consider this as treated as what, either cats or dog. Okay. So it's a sparse categorical cross entropy is considered as a loss function. And our job is what, reduce the loss function. And that's why we are using the sparse categorical cross entropy. And with the respect to that matrix is with respect to the accuracy. We need to calculate the matrix and take that model summary. Definitely, as looking in the case of the previous one, we can say that what it consists of a blocks like this. Convolutional layer is there. And so this is an input image. And come to the point of parameter calculations. Okay. So this is we can see that this is a 896 over here. How we get that 896 over here? Okay. Can you imagine that? And this is with respect to this is with respect to the calculation. And if you are going to consider this as a stride, and the parameter is going to consider with respect to like this, the kernel size into stride plus 1 into filters. And suppose if you are going to consider this as a stride is equal to 1 to 1, and in our example we can say that what already we mentioned that what, how many size of that kernel is 3/3. Okay, so our size is what, 3/3. Kernel size is 3/3. Okay, so it's a 3/3. That means 3 into 3 is equal to 9. We are considering that 3 into 3 is equal to 1. Stride is 1. And we need to, and plus we need to, what should be the total number of filters? We can see that what should be the number of total filters. How many filters are there? 32 filters are there. Okay, so the 32 filters are there, and the total 32 filters are, I'm using over here. So it, okay, so into 32, this means for 320 parameters are there. Okay, so we got the 320 parameters over there. 320 parameters plus what, the input shape to be considered over here. Okay, so we need to find the kernel size and with respect to the padding and striding. We can calculate, or there is a, if there is a dropout of there or something else, and we need to calculate that parameter, and that parameter is considered as what, the total number of the parameters to be considered here, of which considered as what, 896. Okay, like that, in case like that we can calculate what this is the size. Wait. Okay, so next job is what already we are mentioning about the training, and take the summary of that model, and we need to train that entire model using that epochs. You can see that over here. Okay, so I'm going to use the 100 epochs over here, and with a function called the model.fit generator, and I'm passing that train data, and steps for the epochs is again it's a sealed function with respect to this one. And already we mentioned about case. So you can see that epochs is going to 100. Oh, wait, I need to change this to 10 or something else. Wait, that's the best choice. Otherwise, it will be. I'm going to change this one. Fine. You can see that according to that, total number of the size of the batch, you can see that the training is going to happen. And you can see that here the accuracy is only the 49.83. And you can see the validation loss is 69.69. And accuracy is, you not bother about the case of the validation accuracy. I can see that the only thing that it not be deal to a overfitting conditions, and definitely the validation loss to be reducing, and it will, yeah, and also the accuracy cannot be reached to that maximum, 0.9 and something else. It cannot be happen like that, that it leads to that overfitting. Okay, and also already we are avoiding that overfitting, we are using that batch size operation over here. And after that training operations, you can see that what an accuracy with respect to the metrics called accuracy, we need to print that validation accuracy as well as loss and the range of that case. And already you can plot that entire scenario. You can see that the training accuracy is over here. Training accuracy is over here. And of course, this is a good one. We can say that this is a, whether this is a good one or not. We need to what? Train in a more number of epochs. Then only we can say that. Anyway, it does not lead to what in your off-field conditions. Okay. So, and through these ways, and then we need to what? We can use a predict conditions. So our model is ready with this case, and we can say that what after the conditions, you can what use a predict operations for the, or you can use what a test loss as well as test accuracy with respect to what the model dot model underscore CNN dot evaluate functions with respect to a test data set as well as test class. Here we did not created a test data set, only the validation data set. That's why we are stopping over here. We need to calculate that case, and if we have a test data set, definitely we can calculate the test accuracy with respect to the function called evaluate, CNN.evaluate function or model.evaluate. And if you want to predict a particular input image only, we can use that model.predict function to use to predict the particular class. Okay. I think due to that short time, I convey my idea with respect to what the CNN and how it can be implemented for an RGB image, as well as what are the different output in between the different hidden layers. Okay. Once again, I'm going to make a thanks for the organizers to invite me to participate this FTP series. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Now it's the time for questions. Participants, please type in your queries into the chat box. Participants can type in your queries to the chat box. So, no queries yet. That was such an interesting and understanding session, sir. I would like to extend a sincere gratitude to Dr. Sriraj for this amazing session and for expressing the complex CNN in such an understandable manner. The presentation was well packed with explanation and demonstrations, and that too with the constraints of time. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.
And I thank all the participants for joining with us today, and we'll see you tomorrow at 11 a.m. sharp. So we are winding up for today. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And if you want to contact Pardon?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If anyone of the participants may contact, if they want to contact, and please use my mail ID.
Okay, sir.
My mail ID is sriraj.sac@gmail.com. I will mention, I'm typing in the chat box.
Okay, sir. Okay.
If there is...
Okay, sir, we got it. Thank you, sir.